Hi, I'm Susan Taylor with Scripps Health in San Diego, California. Atrial fibrillation, or AFib as it's called, is when the upper part of the heart races, a heart rate of more than 100 beats per minute. But there's some new, less invasive technology to treat AFib. Joining us to talk about this is Dr. Doug Gibson. He is a cardiac electrophysiologist with the Scripps Clinic Medical Group in La Jolla, California. He is the director of cardiac electrophysiology at the Scripps Previs Cardiovascular Institute. Doctor, thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you for having me.
So go into more detail. What exactly is AFib?
So atrial fibrillation is the most common arrhythmia that we humans get. It's centered in the upper chambers of the heart. The upper chamber heart muscle basically spits out very rapid electrical signals, which makes the heart race, beat fast, and causes various symptoms in patients.
And what causes it?
Genetics plays a big role, but things like high blood pressure, obstructive sleep apnea, valvular heart disease, there's a wide variety of medical illnesses that will contribute to it.
And what are the symptoms?
Symptoms can include palpitations, shortness of breath, lightheadedness. It predisposes patients to the risk of stroke, so it can be a nasty little illness.
And what triggers it? Because it doesn't happen all the time, right? It kind of comes and goes.
Yeah, so you have to have the abnormal heart muscle, again, centered in the left upper chambers where the illness starts. And then there's a long list of things that will trip that into high gear. In other words, cause it to spit out these rapid electrical signals, things like stress, dehydration, lack of sleep, alcohol. Unfortunately, there's a syndrome out there called holiday heart. So around the holiday season, right on cue, patients will have a few more drinks with family and they'll show up. We'll have a rash of visits to the ER over the holiday season because of excess alcohol use.
So who is most at risk?
Atrial fibrillation is typically an illness of our older patient population. Above the age of 75 years, about 15% of us will get it. But we're also seeing a rash of young people with it as well. Younger populations are coming in more commonly.
What does it put you at risk for?
So it makes you feel bad, number one, and also increases your risk of stroke. So that's sort of our job taking care of this. We want to minimize the risk of stroke and make people feel better.
And does it give you a higher risk for blood clots?
Yeah, in the atrium, and that's what causes the stroke, there's a pouch that hangs off the left upper chamber of the heart. I'm not sure it shows up so well on this heart model, but up here in the left upper chamber of the heart, we have a pouch, blood can pool in there, clots can form, they can go through the heart to the brain, and that's how you get a stroke from this illness.
So how do you diagnose AFib?
So we have various tools that we can record it with. If you come into the office, we can hook you up to a machine and catch it there, or we can send you home with a monitor. If AFib comes and goes, we'll typically send you home with a monitor and wait for it to happen at home and record it on a monitor.
So how do you treat it?
So medications are our first line of therapy. Medications do have some side effects and they don't always work, so we can escalate from there. We have interventional procedures that we can do to cure it. Certain blood thinners for prevention of stroke. And we also have a mechanical device we can put in the heart to prevent stroke in patients who are not good candidates for blood thinners.
So talk about this new less invasive technology to treat it. What is pulsed field ablation? How does that work?
So when medicines fail, we typically go in and we get rid of the abnormal heart muscle that causes the arrhythmia. Historically, we've used thermal energy to heat up and destroy the abnormal heart muscle. We now have a new way to ablate abnormal heart muscle. Ablation is just a fancy word for getting rid of the abnormal heart muscle. We now use the pulsed energy, so we deliver pulses of energy at the abnormal heart muscle, and it has a unique mode of getting rid of the abnormal heart muscle that's much safer and more effective.
But this is not major open heart surgery, right?
No, this is done. The patient is sedated. They're asleep for the procedure, but we thread catheters through the groin up into the heart. So very, very minimally invasive procedure.
And how long does the procedure take?
Under an hour now. That's one of the advantages of the new therapy. It's much quicker, safer, more effective, but phenomenally shorter.
So what's the downtime after the procedure? Does the patient spend the night in the hospital?
Most of our patients are going home same day after this procedure. We keep them for about 4 hours, make sure they're fine, and then they can go home same day. We're happy to keep patients overnight. It's just most of the patients want the heck out of the hospital, so it's nice in that regard. Older patients later in the day, we may keep them for safety reasons, but probably 90% of our patients are going home same day after this procedure now.
And how soon before you can resume your normal activities, such as walking or running or playing baseball?
So patients can be totally functional around the house, even the night of the procedure, outside walks, short walks, day 3 to 4, day 5, I have them start back to exercise. By day 10, they can do whatever they want, anything they were doing prior to the ablation.
Is there anybody who is not a candidate for this minimally invasive procedure?
So generally, patients should be highly symptomatic to undergo this procedure. The AFib should be bothering them to a reasonable degree in their life. And then there's sort of the standard contraindications. The older and more frail a patient is, we'll generally not consider them for this kind of procedure. Pregnancy, obviously, is a big no-no for many types of procedures.
So there's lots of reasons why you might be short of breath and have heart palpitations. When should you go see a doctor?
Yeah, so obviously all of us will have palpitations and shortness of breath if we're out running a marathon. So I would think if you're sitting around not doing anything, heart's racing, and you're feeling poorly, that would be time to check in with your doctor.
Any final thoughts, doctor?
Yeah, so this is your heart. It's AFib, and we're dealing with strokes and symptoms. So it's extremely nice to have a major revolutionary advance like this. I guess that's the point I'd like to make most strongly. This is like a once-in-a-career revolutionary therapy change for ablation. We were at the forefront of this. We did basic research studies that led to the FDA approval. Super excited to have it. Super excited to finally be able to use it in the patients that are suffering from AFib.
Doctor, thanks so much for taking the time to be with us. We appreciate it.
Thank you, Susan. Thank you for having me.
If you want more information on the latest advancements to treat AFib, just click on the link or go to scripps.org/videos. Want more critical information about your health? Please subscribe to our Scripps Health YouTube channel and follow us on social media at Scripps Health. At Scripps, we're here for good. I'm Susan Taylor. Thanks for joining us.